Aloha, ahi ahi kako, aloha kakahiaka, aloha awinala, good evening, good morning, good afternoon, wherever you are joining us from all over the world. Welcome to our free healing evening this evening at Master Shah's Tao Center in Hawaii. I'm Malia Davidson and the director of this beautiful center. You are experiencing right now the calligraphy healing field. This is the field that Master Shah has created, over 45 calligraphies of positive information. The messages that we receive, the messages that we take into our bodies, the messages that we hear, we see, we feel, whatever it is, however it is that we bring it into our system is important. This field is a transformational field. It's a healing art field. It is a field that is not existent in many places in the world. Master Shah has 12 centers around the world, and Hawaii is fortunate to be one of them. This evening, we commit and we dedicate this time for an hour and a half to your healing. So wherever you are joining us in the world, we welcome you. We welcome you with aloha. That's our way of bringing our light, our love, and our support from these islands of Hawaii to all of you everywhere in the world. And tonight I have my co-host on the island of Maui, Dr. Lori Omuro Yamamoto, my soul sister and partner for many, many years. Aloha, Dr. Lori. I can see her, and she is here to assist with everyone. Yeah, keep her up, please. She is here to assist everyone that's on the line who may have a question, or if you're new and you've never been exposed to Master Shah ever before, she's a great one to ask. We also have many master teachers on the line, as well as advanced healers that are here to support your wellness, your healing. And so as our ohana takes on this kuleana, our ohana is our family. And it's ohana is more than just family in Hawaii. Ohana is a commitment to each and every soul, no matter where you are on your journey. We will do our best to support you in whatever area, whatever stage you are in your healing, in your development, in your soul journey. We do our best. And so I have, I just want to recognize some people that are in the room. Actually, one particular person who is in the room at this time. And I highlight her because, you know, she's an example to all of us. And she's sitting like right across from me. And whenever I see her, she makes me happy because this is our popo, Auntie Evelyn. Auntie Evelyn is 93 years old. And I say that because she practices Master Shah's wisdom. She is independent as well. She still drives and she still lives on her own. It's amazing. So when I'm her age, I hope I'm like as strong as her. So I'm gonna keep doing these practices because we have someone in our midst. We also have Auntie Annette, who is right here in on the island of Maui. I'm gonna highlight Auntie Annette on the line right now. Where's Auntie Annette? There she is. So Auntie Annette is in her 80s. And she also practices. She is a master teacher of the Tao Academy. But you know what? When you see Auntie Annette getting up on chairs and doing and hanging things, and I'm like, but you know what? She's so strong. She's grounded because she continues to practice and she continues to teach our seniors the importance of the Qi channel, of the seven soul houses, of all of the areas of the body that can help to strengthen each and every one of us. So they have many more years over me. And so I watch them. I watch them like a hawk because they do the practices as Master Shah has lined them up for us. And they're simple. They're simple. So we just got to follow. And we got to, you know, because he's so our teacher. Our teacher, Dr. and Master Jigong Shah, is a traditional Chinese medicine doctor as well as a Western medicine doctor. He has been committed to the service of humanity for decades. From when he was 6 years old, Master Sha started to learn Tai Chi, actually one of the toughest forms of Tai Chi, from a grandmaster who allowed him to be his disciple. This is something that is not common. We see many people in China in their older age, in their senior age, doing Tai Chi all across China. Master Sha started when he was 6 years old, and he mastered this form of Tai Chi by the time he was nine. He then went into many art forms, Kung Fu, Qigong, the I Ching, Feng Shui. He became the grand master of these very unique traditional arts. And so we are fortunate that we have a teacher who brings together all of these forms, and he brings it to us and he spoon feeds it to us. Why? Because it's not, we're not monks in the middle of the mountain or high up in the mountain studying, 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 studying. We're not doing that. We're right here in everyday life, whether we're raising children, grandchildren, we're taking care of health conditions, we're doing community service, we're serving on boards, we're doing all kinds of things, right? We don't always necessarily have those hours to commit 10, 12, 24 hours to learn. Master Sha has dedicated his life, as I said, since the age of six. He has learned over and over again. He's been awarded many, many humanitarian awards for his selfless service. He calls himself the servant of humanity, and he's serious about that. His master teachers are all over the world as well. I am fortunate to be one. In Hawaii, there are 20 master teachers in Hawaii, and Hawaii has some of the most, actually. Our numbers are higher than most places in the world, and there is a reason for that. As most people of you, or most of you know here, we are in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. We are susceptible to everything, to wind, to rain, to all kinds of storms. We have volcanoes, we have snow on the mountains. I know many of you don't know that. That has come joining us from all around the world. You can get frostbite on the top of on Mauna Kea or on Haleakala or in Waialeale, wherever it is that you are in the chain. That is possible. It's not something that is always highlighted, but our unique ecosystem is not only very unique, but it's also fragile. So we are here tonight to not only support ourselves in our healing, but as I continue to ask every single person who comes to this broadcast, whether you're online or here in person, whenever we start to heal ourselves, we are also bringing the light to these islands, to the places where you are in the world, wherever you are in the world. Our planet needs help. She needs us to pay attention, and she needs us to be more focused and aware of what we can do for her. She has done much for us. She has bathed us, she has clothed us, she has sheltered us, she has done everything in her power to make sure that we are cared for. So, in return, Master Sha says, follow nature's way. This is part of that. As we are healing, as we are receiving positive information from this field, whether it's this field or in Australia or in Belgium or in Germany, wherever the field is that Master Sha has created, it's about bringing together oneness, in joining hearts and souls together as one. So I'm going to have Dr. Lori put on a video to help us to learn more from Master Sha, just a short one, and that we can introduce Master Sha to those of you who are new to him and to hear his voice. Thank you, Dr. Lori.
Millions of people meditate, positive thinking, and a special healing mantra or healing song, wonderful. But I think mind over matter is not enough. The next step is soul over matter. Soul over matter, soulfulness means our soul can make things happen.
Master Zhigong Sha studied to be a medical doctor in Western medicine from China. Through this journey, he came to learn of a 5,000-year-old practice in traditional Chinese medicine. This revolutionized both his practice and his healing gifts. This is his story.
When I was in a medical college, Xi'an Medical College, one time I think at the restaurant, the meat spoiled. Then I took it, then I have vomiting, diarrhea, and my intestine cramp. Then midnight, I went to emergency. They give me injection in modern medicine. Nothing works. Ayoh, pain. I drink water, pull throughout. I have a classmate. He is the traditional Chinese medicine lineage family. But he studied modern medicine as me classmate. And he came down to my room. He said, lie down. I lie down, lie on the stomach. And he put his hands on my inner thigh and also my lower back. And he said, relax. He moved the finger, moved my tendon. I was shouting, wow, very painful, and very forceful, move my tendon. And then he said, drink the water. I said, I cannot drink anything. He said, big bowl of water, drink it. I drink it. I was totally okay. I have such a deep impression. I said, wow, Chinese medicine, 5,000 years history. There must be something.
This experience, along with many more, changed Master Sha's trajectory from studying strictly Western medicine to also studying traditional Chinese medicine. He received his MD degree in Western medicine from China. He also became a doctor of traditional Chinese medicine and acupuncture. As a lifelong student of ancient Chinese wisdom, Master Sha has come to learn this one eternal truth.
Millions of people in China know these three words, Shen, Qi, Jing. But I have realized Shen, Qi, Jing is more than people understand.
In traditional Chinese medicine, Shen, Qi, Jing are known as the three jewels or three treasures. Shen is the soul, Qi is energy, and Jing is essence or matter. Master Sha has learned and further teaches that everything and everyone is made up of soul, heart, mind, energy, and matter. Or in other words, we are all made up of Shen, Qi, Jing.
During my study, through the whole life, I have realized Shen, Qi, Jing is a universal law. Everyone, everything is made of Shen, Qi, Jing. Shen includes soul, heart, and mind. So in spiritual realm, soul is the spirit. But in quantum physics and Tao science, a soul is the information. They are the same. Millions of people believe here, soul and spirit. Millions of people believe scientific way. But in fact, they are the same. Information is your soul. So therefore, this is like an information system we share with humanity in Tao science.
To further explain, the soul is the warehouse where information is stored. Our heart is the receiver, which transmits the information to the mind. Our mind is the processor or interpreter of the information received. Our mind, in turn, directs the energy and initiates actions. This energy, or qi, dictates the actions of matter. Matter, known as jing, can be defined as our physical body, physical environment, and physical circumstances. Knowing this, both the positive and negative information we consume play a crucial role in the outcome of our lives.
Positive information causes greater results for health, relationship, finances. If you connect with negative information, you are affected. We do Tao Calligraphy. We connect with the source. This is a positive information.
Tao calligraphy is a revolutionary healing art based on an ancient form of one-stroke calligraphy, Ibitsu, which he learned from the soul lineage holder, Professor Li Chu Yun. Master Sha further developed this oneness writing to create a powerful vibrational field that carries the positive messages of Tao's source, such as the greatest love, forgiveness, harmony, flourishing, and more. Through this, we can transform negative information and energy in our own vibrational field by absorbing the positive information and energy generated through tracing of Tao calligraphy. This can result in positive changes and profound healing in our lives, as has been the case for hundreds of thousands of people whom Master Sha has served.
Tao calligraphy creates source healing field that can serve all life, including health, relationship, and finances. I am delighted and excited to invite you to join the masterclass taught by Master Teacher Vanessa, Rejuvenation, Prolonged Life, as well as Transformation of Relationship and Finances. Welcome you.
Thank you. Thank you, Master Sha. That's my teacher. Yeah, take a deep breath. Take a deep breath. Yeah, there are many people who need this information. And so we're going to start this day. Normally I do it way before we even on camera. But I'm going to do it right now because I think we could all use a good piece of information. This is a song that Master Sha created. Well, actually, he didn't create it. He received it in the Mur Woods in California. He asked the source, the divine, would you please give us a song for the mission? And this was many years ago. And this is what came. And please feel free if you know this song. It's called Love, Peace, and Harmony. Lula, lula, li. Received that, and of course he's asking, what does that mean? And he is told that this is soul language, so all souls will know what he's saying because it goes straight to the soul. The information goes straight to the soul. It's universal. So then he translates it into Chinese, his language. 我爱我心和灵，我爱传人类，万灵融合无息，相爱平安和谐，相爱平安和谐。 So then, of course, a huge population will not know what he's talking about. So then he translates it into English. I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace, and harmony. Love, peace, and harmony. Now we sing it in Hawaiian. E aloha mai au. E aloha kako. Aloha, maluhi, alokahi, in soul language. Lula, lula, li. Lula, lula. I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace, and harmony. Love, peace, and harmony. So in every Master Shah's books, he says, the purpose of life is to serve. To serve is to bring happiness and health to others. To serve is to bring empowerment and enlightenment to others. So that is what we're doing this evening, to bring the empowerment and the enlightenment to every part of your being, your soul, heart, mind, energy, and matter, your Shen Qi Jing, through the Tao Calligraphy healing field. So I see we have 41 people on the line this evening. Congratulations. We have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, including me, 11 in the room. We have, these numbers are continuing to grow. Thank you, thank you, thank you to everyone who is starting to come, to bring your friends, to bring your family. These evenings are powerful. We take care of our ohana first. Our ohana is all of us on the line first, because whether you're a healer or you're coming for the very first time, whether you're from the islands of Hawaii or you're from all over the world, you are now part of our ohana. So in the mountain, we say, first day you're a guest, second day you're ohana, which means that you can cook, you can clean, you can do toilets, you can do whatever it is that we need you to do. I don't want to scare you away, but in the mountain, that's what we say. You know, when you come to my house, first day you're a guest, the next day you can make your own food. You can go in the fridge and make your own food. You can make your own bed. But I'm serious about that, because each and every one of us has a job to do. You've been born for a reason. And if you have come to Master Shah, then you have a high level of enlightenment that's already in existence within you. You have a high level of awareness that's already within you. That's why you have found Master Shah. And so it is our job to help you to bring wellness, to bring this light to every part of our being. And this evening, I'm going to work on one particular calligraphy. I'm going to highlight greatest forgiveness. So greatest forgiveness, Uncle Greg, I want to make sure that this is highlighted. Greatest forgiveness. Greatest love brings, love melts all blockages and transforms all life. Forgiveness brings inner peace and inner joy. We have many people. The other night, right across the street from us, there was a man who was sitting across the street, and he was reading a book. It was very late at night, and it was obvious that he was homeless. And so I went to sit with him for a little while. And he's very passive, very gentle man, sitting with his book and just writing. And I brought him some food, and I just watched him. I didn't ask too many questions, and I just watched him. And then in that 5 minutes of time that I was just watching him, sitting next to him, there was another person that came from across the street and was very not happy. And he I was sitting next to the garbage can, he kind of threw rubbish in the garbage can. But he didn't have very many nice things to say. He was actually quite violent in his words. And I thought, right outside our center, they're suffering. Right outside your house, you may not know your neighbor. They may be suffering. I don't know about you guys, but I definitely was brought up to have a mask. Always put on a smile.
no matter how tough it was. But it's really tough for many people out there, and they really need help. So as we work on ourselves, our light, the light that you receive this evening, will go out to others. When you go home, it'll be in your space. If you start doing the practice, it'll go out to your animals or your family members, the lands that you are sitting on, sleeping above. It goes out to everything. Shen, Qian, Jing, your energy moves out to everything. Not just you. Everything you receive this evening, the information, the love, the light from this field, all moves within you. From the cells in your body, the messages in your cells, from the top of your head to the bottom of your feet, your skin to your bones. It will be there. And we are all creation of the source. So we already have that within us. This is bringing it out even more, because we forget. That's the truth. We forget because we get bombarded by not so great messages. Whether the messages are people going nyang, 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 here, or the pain that's in our bodies, that's sore. We come together to help each other. Master Shah says, when we practice together, all of the practice is exponential. So tonight we have, those numbers are growing. I think before the end of the night, we'll have 60 people. When you times 1 hour of practice by 60 people, that's 60 hours of meditation, everyone. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that's a whole week's worth for many of us. That's why I like to do group practice. Because I like to cut to the chase. How can we do this faster? All right. So greatest forgiveness. Greatest forgiveness brings inner joy and inner peace. And what do we need to heal? Inner joy and inner peace. So I'm going to trace this. So for those of you who are new on the line, watch the pathway. We go around three times, two, three. And then we go inside. This is Dao. Quan, Shu, greatest forgiveness. You know, Hawaiians were very strong believers of Ho'oponopono, to make things correct, to make them correct. And so ho'o is the action of pono, which is to make correct. If you add two words of the same thing, pono and pono, this is really an important piece of our understanding and our enlightenment, to make that creation happen, to make that correction happen, to bring it into balance, yeah? So let us, for those of you who are new, we place our hands together like this, if you can, okay? We have Dr. Greg in the room tonight. He actually has had patients who actually couldn't move. And so they would trace with their eyes, and he can talk a little bit about that later. But right now, for those of you who can, this is our lower dantian. This is sometimes I'm thinking in Chinese, sometimes I'm thinking in Hawaiian, and sometimes I'm like, what is it in English? Sorry. This is our power pack right here. This is our energy center that brings energy and light to all of our body, okay? All of our systems and organs. So if you visualize light in this area, golden light ball in this area. So close your eyes for a moment. And visualize that golden light ball or the sun in this area, right below your belly button, inward toward the center of your body. Visualize that light. That's your lower dantian. And if you can't see it, it's okay, because it's still there, whether you can see it or not. All right. So when we trace, we're going to use the five elements. The five elements consist of wood, fire, earth, metal, and water in that order. Wood, fire, metal, and water. So when we bring our fingers together like this, we are now bringing that five elements together as one. We're going to put it down here where our energy center is, and we're going to trace from this area, okay? So I'm going to be still using the stick so that for those who are new to this, they can still see the pathway. But I want you to trace from here, okay? If it's comfortable for you to stand, please do so. If you're doing this for the first time and you're like, oh, I don't know, maybe I'll just sit down, that's fine too. You can do this even laying down. We have those who are not mobile and they can lay down. The only thing, the only rule when you're laying down is be silent when you chant, okay? Because we don't want you to lose energy from the body. We want you to gain energy into the body, all right? Otherwise, let's go, all right? All right, so you can stand, you can sit, whatever makes you comfortable. Be comfortable in this practice. This is a part of our taking care of ourselves this evening. Each and every one of you have chosen and selected to choose yourself in this space and time, and we honor that. So can you see? Everybody can see? Okay, so we use our tracing power with our fingers, and we're also going to use sound power. I'm going to say Da Quan Shu. I'm going to sing it, and please join me. Please join me, okay? If you're new to this, it's not that hard. Just listen a little bit, okay? Here we go. Da Quan Shu. Da Quan Shu. Da Quan Shu. Da Quan Shu. And I'm going to finish this up. This is, and go back to the top. That is one round, okay? Da Quan Shu. So now, everyone in the room and on the line, select one area, one or one condition, or one health problem that you may be having. You're going to ask Da Quan Shu to please give you a blessing. Okay, so if you have diabetes, then you choose diabetes, that health condition. If it is your digestive system, you choose that. If it is your liver or your gallbladder or your lungs, you choose that. Okay? And I'm also going to let you choose a relationship. So either one, right? One thing, you can add a relationship to that. Okay? Who do you need help with? I think we can all think of one person in our life that we love so much. Oh, we're having such a challenge with, but we need more help. Yeah. Okay. Greatest forgiveness brings inner joy and inner peace. All right. Here we go. Da Quan Shu. 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 Da Quan Shu.
Kuan Chu. Greatest forgiveness. 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 Da Quan Chu. 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 So I want you to chant silently now. Place the tip of your tongue to the roof of your mouth. Why is that important? Because it is a joining of the Ren and Du meridians of the body. These are two major meridians of the body, in the front and in the back of the body. When you place your tip of your tongue to the roof of your mouth, you are bringing them together. And you continue to chant greatest forgiveness or Da Quan Chu silently. The practice is done fast and loud, Da Jiang. Yin is soft or silent and slow. I'm going to use my hands now. Keep tracing. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. For those of you who are not experiencing this at all, and you're just learning for the first time, we trace with our hips. This is where your power pack is, right? Your energy center. So when you trace the calligraphy, just as you did with your hands, with your hips, it's actually the energy starts to do it exponentially. If you can, okay? If you cannot, it's okay. It's okay. We work up to that, all right? Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Two more times. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. One more time. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. So finish tracing the calligraphy all the way to the bottom and back to the top again. Okay, everyone, just stare at the calligraphy. Stare at the calligraphy for 30 seconds. Receive this information. Greatest forgiveness. For some of you, while you were tracing, maybe somebody popped in your head that you are trying to give forgiveness to or receive forgiveness from. That happens more often than not. Or maybe it was a situation or incident. Or maybe it's just with your body giving forgiveness, saying, I'm so sorry. So sorry. And then close your eyes and allow that light to come into your body. Everything, just be quiet. And as you are standing or sitting or laying down, wherever you are, just be still. Da Quan Chu. Da Quan Chu. Mandarin for everything is perfect. Everything's well. And we face it. Oh, I'm hot. I don't know about you guys, but I'm like hot. Okay. How's everybody doing? Kealoha Kalani's like, hot, hot. You know, that's a big deal for me, actually, because my hands and my fingers are usually, my hands, my fingers and my toes and my feet are usually cold. So I know that whenever I'm doing these practices, it's like the chi starts to run in my body and then balanced again. So that's just it's hot. It's just to keep in mind. Master Shah is emphasizing the chi channel a great deal. We learned from Dr. Gina, who is also our in-house acupuncturist and master teacher here in Hawaii.
about what happens when the first soul house or the first chakra is not grounded. And what happens is that the energy can be scattered. And when the energy is scattered, then your brain goes and gets all. So I learned something from her that day, because there's lots of confusion happening these days. There's a lot of misunderstandings that can easily happen. And so these practices help to ground us, whether you're tracing greatest forgiveness or greatest love or the heart or the small intestines or whatever it is that you're tracing. It's starting to bring more balance and awareness to the soul, heart, mind, energy, and matter. These are powerful calligraphies, and Master Shah is bringing source light, source frequency. Okay, so we are going to, I'm not sure why my Zoom is not working, but it's not working, but that's okay, this one is. So who is online this evening? I see 43 people online, wonderful. We have a special demonstration this evening, a special demo this evening. And for those of you who are on the line who may not be from Hawaii, I'm going to give a little bit, if that's okay, Uncle, I'm going to give a little brief introduction of our demo this evening. It's somebody that I actually just met not too long ago. And it's really interesting how the heavens bring, how the divine brings people into your space. I was sitting with him, and I didn't know who he was. And it wound up being he and I on the table alone for a moment. And then I got to know who he was, who he is. As many of you know, I am very connected to people who are doing work on the mountain and doing work on the ocean. And in Hawaii, those two positions, those people who do the work in the mountains and in the oceans are extremely valuable. Most times you will never see them because they're doing the work. And they are making sure that our waters are safe. They're making sure that our forests are okay. They're making sure that people are safe. They are making sure that they're taking check, they're taking notice of what's happening with the shifts and the changes in our oceans. They're voyaging, they're reteaching people the ancient arts of Hawaiian wayfinding, or actually it's all over Polynesia. And tonight we have one of these people in our midst, and I'm going to try not to cry because, you know, when we have people who have dedicated their time and energy without, you know, they're just asked, we want you to do this, and they show up. They show up to do it because, and you know, at the time, I can only imagine, and he can tell us if I'm right or wrong, but I can imagine at the time that they didn't really know what impact this was going to make, but they knew that for the Hawaiian people, it was going to reconnect us to our ancient ones. And they knew, they hoped, I think, that this would revitalize or rejuvenate a whole peoples. And that's what happened. Just a few years ago, 5 years ago, Hokulea, which is our double hull sailing canoe, and Hiki Analia, for a little bit of that voyage, went across the world. It circumnavigated the world based on the stars, no modern technology. And this is something that has been dedicated. There have been a few people who started this, who started that dream, Herb Kane, Pinky Thompson. And our guest is one of those tonight who was amongst that original grouping, who had something to do. He had kuleana, he had responsibility in this. And I'm, you know, I don't want to make him embarrassed, but you know, I have great love and respect for these men and women. I have this just 2 days ago, I was on a plane 3 days ago, and it's really, this is one of those heaven sent things again. I was the last one on the plane because I had a consultation to do right before I got on the plane. And so I was running to get on my plane and kind of stumbling. And who was on the plane but Hokulea's captain, Archie Kalepa. And he looked over at me and I went, "Uncle Archie." And then 2 days ago, I'm in the presence of Uncle Billy. So I'm going to ask someone to help Uncle Billy to come up here as he is the demo for this evening. And Dr. Gray, can you help him with his chair, bring it up here? And I welcome him to, if you can bring the chair, Dr. Greg, thank you. And just bring it up here so he can sit. Yeah, I'm Uncle. Yeah. Can we have a mic for him maybe so that we, yeah. So, you know, I was talking about his uncle actually is one of the builders of Hawaii Loa, which is one of the double hull canoes. It's out of Hawaii Island, yeah? Hawaii Loa.
No, we're going, okay. Well, let me explain real quick. I went to my middle school. I'm 62, I graduated. And because my parents couldn't afford to send me to college, I joined the Marine Corps. I went in the Marine Corps for 6 months, and I came out and I got in the police department. But these are all the kind of things that, again, coming from the island of Molokai, and getting, going to Kamehameha school. But one of my classmates, Wright Bowman, his father was our wood carving teacher at Kamehameha, and he lived at Bishop Museum. One day I get a call, "Billy, we're gonna cut some log, can you come and help us?" So my classmate, Palani Vaughn, and a whole bunch of other classmates, we went down there, and for about 6 months we spent time cutting the logs, and we built the Hawaii Loa. Uncle Pinky Thompson, who Nainoa Thompson's father, he was there, and he asked Mr. Bowman, he says, "Who's that guy over there?" He says, "Well, his name is Billy Arnellis. I'd like to have him join the Polynesian Voyaging Society." And so for about 30 some odd years, I served on the Polynesian Voyaging Society. Mike Tong, Mike was an attorney. Well, this is another part of my story. When I was in the police department, they started what's called the Law Enforcement Education Program. And this is for law enforcement officers to go and get college degrees. And so we all started Honolulu Community College, got a 2-year degree, went to Chaminade, got a 4-year degree. One day I get a call, "Billy, we're gonna have a meeting upstairs, 5 o'clock, come upstairs." "What about?" "It's for law school." I said, "I can't afford to go to law school." Anyway, 5 to 5, they're yelling in the hallway, "Law school meeting upstairs." I go upstairs, they introduce us to the second year law student. He says, "Today's Thursday, the law school test is Friday, so I'm Saturday." I asked, "What do we need to study?" He said, "You don't know it today, not gonna know it by Saturday." They introduce him, his name was John Wahee. Anyway, I took the test and I got into law school. I worked midnight shift, went to school during the day. My daughter was 1 year old. I'd pick her up in the morning, take her to the babysitter, go to my law school class, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, go under the tree, take a nap, get up 1 o'clock, go back to, you know, I finished in 4 years, I got my law degree. And I was then called one day and they said, "There's this program called Crime Stoppers. We want to see it." I started the program Crime Stoppers. I started about 41 years ago. Anyway, these are some of the kind of things that I've been involved in over the years. And I was at this convention that we have every year. It's a Hawaiian convention. It's put on by the Council for Native Hawaiian advancement. And I was sitting there and I met Malia. And we were talking and I told her I had a stroke about 18 months ago and I'm still recovering. And she told me about this healing process. And so that's why I'm here. But part of it, like I say, is, you know, I was in the Marine Corps, I was a paratrooper, I was a scuba diver, I was a police officer for 25 years, I was an attorney for 39 years. You don't look at failure, you look at success. And so again, I'm here to learn, and I want to get other Hawaiians involved in this kind of therapy.
Thank you. Aww. So I got to know Uncle a little bit, and I was like, oh, so there's my pigeon comes out, I'm sorry, but I was like, oh, Uncle, you hit hammers, yeah, in your class. So hammers are like the big wigs, yeah. The people who he graduated with are the movers and shakers in Hawaii. So I'm really grateful that he trusted us to be here and to be able to receive these blessings this evening. So as,
and
yes,
I also
Uncle.
She went to Kamehameha.
You found out that I went to Kamehameha too.
Part of what Bill's
ohana.
Is built on these kinds of things.
Or ohana is built on these kinds of things. I'm just repeating so that because they have it on mic. So yes, so we are a part of a big ohana. And so we will continue to help our ohana. So for those I have, how many healers do I have? How many master teachers do I have online? Because I can't see, sorry, who's online this evening. If I can get actually, you know what? I might have to just, this might be a sign. Just do it. Just do it. Okay, yeah, it's not coming. For some reason, it's not connecting for me. All right, so I would like Dr. Lori, I can see her. I think we have others online. I'm not sure if Dr. Gina's online. We have Dr. Greg in the room. We have Elizabeth in the room. Please watch. Ke aloha kolani, I believe, also can see. There, I think Kavehi Lani might be online. Those of you who have, Dr. Gina is here, good, perfect. Okay, so please connect with Uncle Billy. What do we need to give him this evening? As always, we make this an opportunity that's a teaching opportunity as well. We all learn what it is that we can do. I'm gonna go behind you, Uncle, so just stay right there. What can we do to support this healing this evening? Yeah. Okay, there we go. All right. So everyone focus in. You can all contribute to Uncle's healing. You know, I just want to say that there are thousands and thousands of people who have benefited from this gentleman and the work that not only Polynesian Voyaging Society has done, but how many of you actually know what Crime Stoppers is? Yeah, most of you know what Crime Stoppers is in Hawaii. How many of you know what Polynesian Voyaging Society is, or the Hokulea, or Hawaii Loa, or Makali'i, or Hikianalia, or, yeah. So most people know. 30 years ago or 40 years ago when they started, almost very few people knew, yeah? So it needed, the pathway needed to be paved for a whole several generations to be able to even start navigating now, yeah? We have young navigators now that are sailing the seas, and it had to start with somebody. It had to start with a dream. It had to start with people who could put that those canoes together, and then of course people to actually sail. We honor Papa Mau for his teaching our people how to sail, once again via the stars, the current, the winds. Yeah, so I'm honored to to support Uncle in his blessings and his healing this evening. So everyone, close your eyes. Oh, okay, he wants to say one more thing. Okay, I'm going to give you this then.
We're carrying on this tradition of Ohana. Our Little League World Series champions have done that also. And so we're going down the next generation. And this morning's paper talked about Ohana up in Williamsport, Pennsylvania.
Thank you.
We're still building on that.
Yes, we had our Little League kids. They won the world Little League Championship baseball. And they were amazing. They're just, wow, they were amazing. And yes, they represented Hawaii very, very well. And everywhere that they went, they were loved. So all of these acts of aloha has started somewhere. And every action, there's a reaction, yeah? So I always look toward the hula revitalization, hokulea, sailing, wayfinding, language, culture, all of those things were really heavy in the 70s, 1976, around that area, right when Uncle was starting to do all of these things. And so thousands of people have been served because this man said yes. Yeah. So close your eyes, Uncle. Everyone, close your eyes and visualize. The condition is stroke. Condition is stroke. And I'm going to check what it is that Uncle needs this evening. How? Okay, so you're gonna keep your eyes closed. This is a very special evening this evening. So every blessing that is given to Uncle, it's a splash. It will be a big splash tonight for all of you who are in the room, who are on the line. He will be given light holes this evening for his three areas. So there's gonna be the light holes, Uncle, are like, you know how the black hole is in the universe? Well, the light hole is sucks out the density of the negative information that's in the body and it fills it with light. So the first one I'm gonna give you is right here, right where your sternum is, where your heart is. And then the second one is right here at your C7. The third one will be right at the bottom of your torso. The Huiyin, so it will be able to interact and pull out all of the things that you don't need now. And Dr. Gray, can you watch, please? And all of those who are on the line, please watch. Okay. So, dear Master Shah's Tao Calligraphy Healing Field, please prepare the Da. Dao light hole for the Shenzhong. Dao order, Dao golden light hole and Dao golden liquid spring for the Shenzhong. For Uncle Billy, can you give your full name three times? And Smith. Give a blessing to all those on the line and all those in the room. The light heals you. The light heals you. The light Thank you. Okay. So if anybody on the line or in the room would like to share what they saw and share it with Uncle Billy, please do so at this time. This is first of three. Yeah. Yeah. Uncle wants to do a pule.
E puli kako, e koma koma kola, e hono ia ko inoa, e hiki mai ko au puni, e malama ia ko make makahu nui nei. Mahalo ke akua, mahalo na ohana, mahalo na aikane. Thank you, God, thank you, family, and thank you, friends. As we join our hands here in a circle of aloha, please bless us all. Thank you for this very, very important healing process. And as you all leave here tonight, please bless us all and let us all get better. No kamea, no ke au puni. Ame ka mana. Ame ka honani o maoloa aku. Amen.
Mahalo. Mahalo. Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay. Thank you, Uncle. Would anyone like to share? Anyone on the line? Pumana?
We have Pumana who shared so much negative information that was affecting this area was removed with an explosion of light that replaced it with so much aloha. So congratulations.
Thank you, Pumana. Okay. Do you feel anything here? Here. Ke aloha o ka Lenny wants to share. Oh, you don't want to be on camera. Okay, that's okay. She doesn't need to be on camera.
Okay. Hi. So when you got the light hole, it was like a pop, and it looked like a gold little hole, and it popped right into the middle of your chest. And then I saw someone like sweeping, like debris, like all the negative stuff is being swept in and sucked out. It was really beautiful.
Beautiful. Thank you. Okay, let's go into the second. The second one is going to be right here, right in your C7. Okay, so everyone focus in because and make a request for what you would like to, because that's how this works. The source is very good to everyone. That's why you want to be in these healing evenings. Okay. So dear Master Shaw's Tao healing field, please prepare golden light hole, golden liquid spring for the Dajway C7 area. Tao order, Tao golden light hole, and Tao golden liquid spring for Uncle Billy for his Dajway transmission. Turn on, join as one, heal him, and bless all those on the line and those who are in the room. Thou treasures heal you. Thou treasures heal you. Thou treasures heal. Thou treasures transforms you. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. All right. Once again, if anybody would like to share on the line, Dr. Gina, are you on the line?
Yes, hello, I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yeah, can we have her on the screen, Uncle? Thank you. Thank you.
Aloha.
Hi. Aloha.
So nice to see you, Uncle. My name is Gina, and I'm so honored to be here with you tonight. One thing that I noticed with the first Tao light hole for your chest area was that it went all the way also into your lower back, and it started to work on your spinal column in your lower back, and the light was going all the way, you know, down the back of your legs too. And then with the second one, I felt like the second one not only improved the strength of your back, or it will improve the strength of your back, but also amplified the opening of the chest. So your circulation is even more enhanced by the second Dajway light hole. Thank you so much, Belia.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Gina. She's our acupuncturist. Yeah. Okay. So one more. One more. So everyone watch. Dear Tao Calligraphy Healing Field, please prepare Tao Golden Light Hole, Tao Golden Liquid Spring for the Huiyin. So this one's at the bottom of your torso. Tao order, Tao golden light hole, and Tao golden liquid spring for Uncle Billy's Huiyin transmission. All treasures join as one transmission. Heal him and bless all those on the line as well as those in the room. Tao treasures heal, 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 Tao treasures heal. Tao treasures heal, Tao treasures heal, Tao treasures heal, Tao treasures heal, transform, 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 transform. Doll treasures, thank you. Doll treasures, thank you. Doll treasures, thank you. How, thank you, thank you, thank you. Love you, love you, love you. Whew, I'm getting hot, 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 hot. Okay. Dr. Greg?
Yes, ma'am.
Come, please.
Yeah. First and foremost, congratulations. You were exceptionally blessed this evening from Master Shaw's amazing abilities.
Yeah.
Billy, I'm a rehabilitation physician for 43 years. I've done many thousands of individuals who have had strokes. What I just saw with my skill sets that I've had for nearly all 43 of those years was with the first transmission that went to your heart. The heart tells the brain what's going on. We didn't really recognize that, but the heart tells the brain what's going on. Your heart was open, and then some of that got transmitted up here to the area where you've had the misfortune or the blessing of having these changes. That transmission was just the start. This second transmission was really very, very remarkable because that really changed the anatomy, the neuroanatomy of your brain was changed. Reconnections were established. The third and lower had everything to do with you being a waterman and your kidneys and bringing all of those aspects throughout your whole body so that these legs of yours that have probably given you some, you've probably missed your sea legs. Is that a fair statement? Okay. Well, I think you're going to find your sea legs are going to come back significantly. How quickly, we don't always know. And one of the other things that's very important for you to remember is that heaven does 50% of the work. You do the other 50% of the work. Have you ever stepped away from a job, sir?
Have I what?
Ever stepped away from a job that was presented to you?
Not really.
Not really, ever, no. Right? No. So it's going to behoove you to continue this. Sometimes it's an instantaneous process, but other times things happen on the other dimensions and they take time. Just like when you started your ventures and working with the hook, it took time. It's linear time. But this was a huge, huge blessing. Again, I say, congratulations. We might sometimes say happy birthday.
Mm-hmm. We do because happy birthday.
Because you have just had, I love the smile. Thank you, sir. Mahalo.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Greg.
Thank you, Master Shaw. Thank you, Master Shaw.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. So I was getting that we all need to continue to contribute to Uncle Billy's condition. So all of our Tao hands healers, we will give Uncle Billy a blessing for his condition, the condition of stroke, okay? So all of us are gonna contribute to this healing and blessing at this time, all right? So go ahead and just, your eyes, Uncle. All of our healers, Tao healers, even if you're not a Tao healer, you can send your love to Uncle Billy, okay? Send your love to Uncle Billy. Doesn't matter whether you're a Dalhans healer or not. We all have this ability within us, and it's just given at different frequencies, yeah? Okay, so all of our Dalhans healers prepare. So dear Uncle Billy, we love you, we honor you, and we deeply appreciate you. You have the power to heal yourself. Do a good job. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Love you. Love you. Love you. Dear our Tao hands, whatever level is most appropriate for Uncle, please give him a blessing that is most appropriate for the condition of stroke. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Love you. Love you. Love you. Blessing begins. Lula, lula, li. Lula, lula, li. Lula, lula, li. Lula, lula, li. Shang I ping on Ha She. I love my heart and soul. I love all humanity. Join hearts and souls together. Love, peace, and harmony. Love, peace, and harmony. E aloha mai'au. E aloha kākou apa. Aloha maluhi alokahi. How? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Love you, love you, love you. Okay. Uncle, how do you feel? You feel better? Yeah? Oh, good. Oh, Elizabeth wants to say something. Oh, I don't have. Oh, there. There. This is for you, Uncle. Sorry. There.
Yeah. Oh, sweet.
Good job.
I'm gonna say hi.
My grandson, excuse me.
Yeah.
Hi boys, this is Papa. I'm in a meeting, okay.
Oh,
that's okay. I think this is part of what I had to say. When I first looked, I saw the stream coming from heaven and this stream going to the center of Earth. And it's worth recognizing that you are already so connected. That heaven is waiting, center of the earth is waiting, And your job is just to make those little connections that got broken. Yeah, and you can do this. And you got lots of help here. But when you're doing your practice, look with your eyes, all kinds of eyes from everywhere. Look for these connections. Yeah, and it's important that you keep those connections and grow these connections. Yeah, because they're there. And everyone's waiting for you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh. So it's been an honor to be with all of you this evening, wherever you are joining us from all around the world. I think, Dr. Lori, do you want to read a few before we go off air today?
Yes, wonderful. We had a lot of people sharing. I'll read what I just saw. Okay. Oh, it's moving.
Can we put her up on?
So it's.
Thank you, Uncle.
Mahalo, another powerful Tao treasure for Uncles Huiyin. I think Auntie Diane also shared for many others. It has created neurogenesis where the nerves are being regenerated for his legs, muscles, tendons, and feet. It will help bring stability to his walking. And Pomana shared several times. I'll read the last post she had. When all the treasures were combined as one to serve Uncle Billy, I literally saw so much more new positive information and light blast through his entire body, head to toe, skin to bone. And I also heard that it will take about 3 to 5 days for your body to fully integrate this, and that you will start to feel much stronger in a week. The entire neurology of your organs, systems, and entire body is going through a major recalibration. So happy for you. This is remarkable. Congratulations. Love you, love you, love you. Well, congratulations.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you. So our free healing evening is available to every single person who has access to internet. Or if you don't, come here. If you live in Oahu, come here. Or it's also on, I think there's Zoom links also have phone. So there's multiple ways to access us, and we want to help people. This is what Master Shaw's mission is, to serve people, to bring healing and wellness to them, to bring empowerment and enlightenment. So many of us work so hard every single day. You work hard in your jobs, you work hard with your families, you work hard in your communities, you're giving, 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 giving. So I thank you for being here this evening with us, for spending this time with us. I thank Uncle Billy for being here with us, for really gifting us with your presence. And all of you on the line, thank you. I know I saw Erkan on, and Erkan, I think it's midnight his time. Thank you all, I can't see all of you tonight on the line, but I thank you all for being here and for just spending this evening with us. Please tell your friends, tell your family, this is where we are, and we will not go away anytime soon. Monday evening, 6 to 7:30 p.m., free healing evenings. Tuesdays, 6 to 7, I believe, is the Love, Peace, Harmony evenings. We are starting a Kupuna program in September 2nd. Auntie Pam will be starting that program from 10 to 11 a.m. every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. It's called the Kupuna Connection, where you will be learning, people will be able learning some of these techniques and be able to just kind of get together and learn in a very safe area within this center. I thank you all. Love you. See you next week. Ke aloha no. Ahui ho.
Thank you. And please join our upcoming intro to self-care with Malia and Hui Ling you can go to drsha.com to register. It's a complimentary session. Aloha.
Thank you. Aloha.